Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the solution and discussion on the gate question paper in Mechanical Engineering subject. And this is lecture number 39. We are going to continue with the radiation heat transfer. In the earlier lecture also, we solved a few problems in radiation heat transfer. We continue with the problems on the radiation heat transfer. The first question from 2013 question paper. Two large diffuse gray parallel plates separated by a small distance have surface temperature 400 Kelvin and 300 Kelvin respectively. If the surface emissivity of the surfaces is 0.8 and Stefan Boltzmann constant is sigma equal to 5.67 × 10⁻¹⁸ watts per meter square Kelvin to the power 4, the net radiation heat exchange rate in kilowatts per meter square between the two plates. So we have four options here. So we will calculate. And here temperature T1 is taken as 400 Kelvin, T2 is taken as 300 Kelvin. Emissivity of both the surfaces are equal. And Stefan Boltzmann constant, it is given. Now we have to calculate heat transfer per unit area for parallel plates, long parallel plates, very large diffuse parallel plates, the shape factor equal to 1, the corresponding equation to calculate the heat flux, that is heat transfer per unit area, sigma T1 to the power 4 minus T2 to the power 4 divided by 1 by epsilon 1 plus 1 by epsilon 2 minus 1. The emissivity of both the surfaces are equal 0.8, so you substitute 5.67 × 10⁻¹⁸, 400 to the power 4 minus 300 to the power 4 divided by 1.8 plus 1 by 0.8 plus 1 by 0.8 minus 1. So calculating the value heat flux equal to 658 watts per meter square, which is 0.658 kilowatts per meter square. The answer given here, the option A is the correct. So option A is given as 0.66 kilowatts per meter square. That is the correct answer. The next question from 2014 question paper. A hemispherical furnace of 1 meter radius has inner surface of emissivity emissivity 1. Inner surface of its roof. Roof is considered as inner surface maintained at 800 Kelvin. While its floor of emissivity 0.5 and it is kept at 600 Kelvin. So the roof of the hemispherical furnace is black with emissivity 1 and the temperature 800 Kelvin and the floor is of emissivity 0.5 and the temperature 600 Kelvin. The Stefan Boltzmann constant is 5.67 × 10⁻¹⁸. The net radiative heat transfer in kilowatts from the roof to the floor is dash. So the answer to the question is 24.3 kilowatt. We will see how in the next slide. So here this is the hemispherical furnace. We have the roof of radius 1 meter, emissivity 1, temperature 800 Kelvin, and this is considered as surface 2. And we consider the floor as the surface 1 with the temperature 600 Kelvin, radius 1 meter and emissivity is 0.5. So we calculate A1. A1 is the area of the base, area of the floor, which is pi r square. So r equal to 1 meter, it is pi. A2. 2 pi r square. So the area of the hemisphere, 2 pi r square. Area of the surface area of the sphere is 4 pi r square. Half of the sphere is hemisphere, 2 pi r square, 2 pi. Now we calculate the heat transfer, Q equal to sigma T2 to the power 4 minus T1 to the power 4. We have to calculate the heat transfer from the roof to the floor divided by all the resistances. So first resistance is the surface resistance of the floor. The second resistance, the shape factor resistance between the floor and the roof, and the third resistance is the surface resistance of the surface 2, that is the roof. So substitute numerical values 5.67 × 10⁻¹⁸, 800 to the power 4 minus 600 to the power 4 divided by 1 minus 0.5 divided by pi into 0.5 plus 1 by pi into 1. So F12 equal to 1 because the radiation which is leaving from the surface 1, it is completely falling on the surface 2.
So A1 F12 equal to A2 F21. So the value is the same because the radiation leaving from the, because it is a closed furnace, the radiation leaving from this surface is completely falling on the other surface. Then resistance 1 minus 1 divided by 2 pi. So 1 minus 1 equal to the third term is equal to 0. So numerator is 15,816 divided by 0.3185 plus 0.3185. So both are 0.3185. So this is equal to 24,831.1 watts or 24.83 kilowatts. That is the answer to the problem. The amount of heat transfer between the roof and the floor is 24.83 kilowatts. The next question from 2014 question paper, two infinite parallel plates are placed at a certain distance apart. An infinite radiation, infinite radiation shield is inserted between the plates without touching any of them to reduce the heat exchange between the plates. Assume that the emissivity of the plates and the radiation shield are equal. The ratio of net heat exchange between the plates with and without the shield, the ratio of heat exchange between the plates with and without the shield is, we have 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4 and 1 by 8. So, the correct answer is 1 by 2, we will see how in the next slide. So, the radiation heat transfer of N shield, so the general expression, the radiation heat transfer with the, for N shield, when the emissivity of all the surfaces, the surface 1, surface 2 and the shield surface, everything is equal, then the equation is simplified as sigma A into T1 to the power 4 minus T2 to the power 4 divided by N plus 1 into 2 by sigma minus 1, where N is the number of shield. When the heat transfer is without shield, suppose there is no shield and we have to, the equation is sigma A into T1 to the power 4 minus T2 to the power 4 divided by 2 by epsilon minus 1. Now look at the two equations. So in the first equation, in the denominator we have N plus 1. Now we write the equation, heat transfer with N shield equal to 1 by N plus 1 into sigma A into T1 to the power 4 minus T2 to the power 4 divided by 2 by epsilon minus 1. Which is equal to 1 by n plus 1 into Q without the shield, the heat transfer without shield. Now, rearrange the terms, Q with the shield divided by Q without shield, heat transfer with the shield divided by heat transfer without shield equal to 1 by n plus 1. Now, we have one shield here in this problem. So, 1 by 1 plus 1 equal to 1 by 2. That is the answer. So, you remember this equation derivation so that where sometimes they may ask the similar type of problem in the GATE examination again. So, the conclusion of the problem, the conclusive equation of the problem is very important. Q without shield, Q with the shield divided by Q without shield equal to 1 by N plus 1. The condition is emissivity of all the surfaces including the shield is the same. The next question from 2015 question paper, the total emissive power of a surface is 500 watts per meter square at a temperature T1 and 1200 watts per meter square at temperature T2, where the temperature are in Kelvin. Assume that the emissivity of the surfaces to be constant, the ratio of temperature T1 and T2 is 0.308, 0.416, 0.803, 0.874. So, we have to calculate the ratio of T1 by T2 from the emissive power. So, we have emissive power E1 equal to 500 watts per meter square and E2 equal to 1200 watts per meter square. And we have E1 by E2 equal to, actually E1 equal to sigma T1 to the power 4, E2 equal to sigma T1 T2 to the power 4. So, sigma is getting cancelled. So, E1 by E2 equal to T1 to the power 4 divided by T2 to the power 4. So, substituting numerical values, 500 by divided by 1200 equal to T1 to the power 4 divided by T2 to the power 4. The ratio is 0.4167. Now, T1 by T2 equal to 0.4167 to the power 0.25, 1 by 4. So, the answer is 0.803. So, the answer is 0.803, option C. The next question from 2016 question paper, an infinitely long furnace of 0.5 meter by 0.4 meter cross section is shown in the figure below. So this is the figure, the furnace of cross section 0.4 meter, 0.5 meter, and it is given as infinitely long. So infinitely long, it is not correct statement. We take the width of the plate is equal to 1 meter. We consider the width of the furnace is 1 meter. That is the length perpendicular to the screen. Consider all the surfaces of the furnace to be black. The top and the bottom walls are maintained at T1 equal to 3, T3 equal to 927 degrees Celsius, while the side walls T2 equal to T4 equal to 527 degrees Celsius. The view factor F12 equal to 0.26. The net radiation heat loss or gain on the side 1. So, what is the heat loss or gain by the surface 1 in watts per meter length? So, here it is given, watts per meter length. So, length actually, the width of the plate, width of the surface, width of the furnace is taken as 1 meter perpendicular to the screen. The Stefan-Boltzmann constant is 5.61 10 power minus 8. So, the answer is 24,530.688 watts per meter. So, we do the calculation in the next slide. So, this is the furnace. So, the length is 0.5 meter and here the height is 0.4 meter and the width perpendicular to the screen is 1 meter. So, T1 equal to T3 equal to 927 degrees Celsius, which is 1200 Kelvin. T2 equal to T4 equal to 527 degrees Celsius, which is 800 Kelvin. F12 is given as 0.26 and sigma is the constant. Now, the symmetry rule, by symmetry, F12 equal to F14 equal to 0.26. F12 is given, F12 equal to F14. So, from here, the radiation is falling on the surface 2, surface 4 and surface 2 and these two are equal. By summation rule, so, F11 plus F12 plus F13 plus F14 equal to 1. So, we have to calculate F13 equal to 1 minus F11 minus F12 minus F14, which is 1 minus 0. So, F11 equal to 0. F12 equal to 0.26. F14 equal to 0.26. So, F13 equal to 0.48. Now, we calculate the radiation heat transfer by the side 1. So, Q equal to Q12 plus Q14 plus Q13, which is equal to Q12 plus Q14, because Q13 equal to 0. Reason is, both the surfaces are at the same temperature. T1 equal to T3 equal to 1200 Kelvin. So, calculating. So, the again for surface 2 and surface 4, the temperature remains the same, 800 Kelvin. So, 2 times of the value heat transfer, sigma A into F12 into T1 to the power 4 minus T2 to the power 4. Now, calculating 2 into 5.67, 10 power minus 8 into area equal to 0.5. So, this is the surface 0.5 into width equal to 1 meter into 0.26 is the shape factor F12 and then 1200 to the power 4 minus 800 to the power 4. The answer is 24,530.688 watts per meter. This is the answer to the problem. The next question from 2016 question paper. Two large parallel plates having a gap of 10 millimeter between them are maintained at a temperature 1000 Kelvin, T1 1000 Kelvin, T2 400 Kelvin. Given the emissivity value epsilon 1.5 and epsilon 2.25 and the Stefan-Boltzmann constant sigma equal to 5.67 10 power minus 8. So, heat transfer between the plate per meter square area, kilowatts per meter square area. So, it is a simple problem. We have to remember this equation for the heat transfer between the two surfaces, two gray surfaces, Q by A equal to sigma T1 to the power 4 minus T2 to the power 4 divided by 1 by epsilon 1 plus 1 by epsilon 2 minus 1. So, this is the final equation. There is a derivation, you can refer to the lecture, theory video lecture for the derivation. So, substituting numerical values 5.61 10 power minus 8 into 1000 to the power 4 minus 400 to the power 4 divided by epsilon 1 1 by 0.5 plus epsilon 2 1 by 0.25 minus 1. So, this is 11,049.696 watts per meter square or 11.05 kilowatts per meter square. So, this is the answer to the problem. The next question from 2017 question paper, two black surfaces AB and BC of length 5 meter and 6 meter. So, respectively are oriented as shown in the figure. So, the figure is shown here, surface 1, surface 2. Both the surfaces extend infinitely into third dimension. Given that F12 equal to 0.5, T1 equal to 800 Kelvin, T2 equal to 600 Kelvin, and the surrounding is 300 Kelvin, and the Stefan-Boltzmann constant is 5.6 on 10 power minus 8. The heat transfer rate from the surface 2 to the surrounding environment is dash kilowatt. So, we have to calculate the heat transfer from the surface 2 and the surrounding, and the answer is 13.778 kilowatt. So, we will see how in the next slide. So, this is the surface, the third surface, surrounding is considered as a third surface, and the surface 2 is of length 5 meter and the surface 1 is of length 6 meter, and the F12 is 0.5, T1 equal to 800 Kelvin, T2 equal to 600 Kelvin, and surface surrounding temperature is 300 Kelvin, sigma is given. Now, area of the first plate, A1 equal to 6 into 1, 6 meter square, A2 equal to 5 into 1, 5 meter square, A1 F12 equal to A2 F21. So, from the reciprocity rule, so F21 equal to A1 F12 divided by A2, so 6 into 0.5 divided by 5 equal to 0.6. Now, F21 plus F22 plus F23 equal to 1. So, F23 equal to 1 minus F21 plus F22. So, F21 is given in the F21 we have calculated 0.6. So, F22 equal to 0. The radiation leaving the surface 2 and falling back onto the surface 2 is 0. So, 1 minus 0.6 equal to 0.4. Now, the heat transfer between the surface 2 and the surrounding, A2 F23 sigma into T2 to the power 4 minus T3 to the power 4. So, substituting numerical values, A2 equal to 5 meter square and F23 equal to 0.4, 5.6 on 10 power minus 8 into 600 to the power 4 minus 300 to the power 4 equal to 13,778 watts or 13.778 kilowatt. That is the answer to the problem. The next question from 2018 question paper, a 0.2 meter thick infinite black plate having thermal conductivity of 3.96 watts per meter Kelvin is exposed to two infinite black surfaces at 300 Kelvin and 400 Kelvin as shown in the figure. So, this is the metal black plate. So, this is this side, left side is 300 Kelvin, right side is 400 Kelvin, and in between the plate and the side wall, it is completely vacuum. At a steady state, the surface temperature of the plate facing the cold side is 350 Kelvin. So, this surface is 350 Kelvin. This is the cold side and this is 350 Kelvin. The value of Stefan-Boltzmann constant is 5.6 on 10 power minus 8. Assume one dimensional heat conduction. The magnitude of heat flux through the plate is dash watts per meter square. So, correct to two decimal places. So, we have to calculate the heat flux on the surface. So, the surface which is facing the cold side. So, the answer is 391.584 watts per meter square. So, we will see how in the next slide, the calculation we will see in the next slide. And this is the configuration. We have the cold plate 300 Kelvin, hot plate 400 Kelvin, and this is the black plate of thickness 0.2 meter, thermal conductivity 3.96 watts per meter Kelvin, and this surface is at 350 Kelvin. Now, we have to calculate the radiation heat flux, radiation heat transfer between the surface 1 and surface 2. So, the epsilon 1 equal to epsilon 2 equal to 1 because both the surfaces are considered black body, F12 equal to 1 because it is a infinite long plate. So, whatever the amount of heat leaving the plate to 1 is completely falling on the surface 2. So, the heat flux between the cold plate and the surface of the black plate, so Q by A equal to sigma into T1 to the power 4 minus T2 to the power 4 divided by the surface resistance, shape factor resistance and the surface resistance once again. So, the surface resistance. So because it is a black body, surface resistance of the both the surfaces are emissivity equal to 1. So the resistance are equal to 0. Shape factor F12 equal to 1. The answer is substituting 5.67 10 power minus 8 into 350 to the power 4 minus 300 to the power 4 equal to 391.584 watts per meter square. The next question from 2019 question paper. Three set of parallel plates LM, NR, PQ are shown in the figure 1, 2, 3. And this is the plate LM, L is the top plate and M is the bottom plate, LM, NR, PQ. The V factor Fi is J defined as the radiation leaving the plate I that is intercepted by the plate J. Assume that the value of FLM and FNR equal to 0.8 and 0.4 respectively. FLM. FLM equal to and FNR. NR equal to 0.4 and 0.8 respectively. The value of FPQ. So FPQ right, is dash round to one decimal place. So we have to calculate. The answer is 0.6. So we will see, we will calculate the value in the next slide.
And this is the diagram once again. So the top plate is L, bottom plate is M. And the M plate M we are dividing into three segments A, B, C and N, R. And Q, the plate Q once again we divide into two segments D and E. So if you look at 1 meter length and here it is 1 meter length, everything is 1 meter length. The value given FLM equal to 0.8, FL to M. So the energy leaving the plate L and is falling on the M equal to 0.8, FNR equal to 0.4. So the plate leaving the heat here and falling on the plate R equal to 0.4, fraction of energy leaving the plate N and falling on the plate R. Now for the plate LM, so the amount of energy leaving the plate L. Now we divide into three segments. Energy falling on the A, energy falling on B, energy falling on C. So FLA plus FLB plus FLC equal to 0.8. And FNR, there is only one plate on both sides. So this is FNR equal to 0.4. So this is what the value given. Now similarity rule. So considering the similarity rule, FLA equal to FLC equal to FPE. Look at here, FLA, FLC, these two are equal. And this FLE, so because it is the segment on the right side, so FPE, that is also equal. So these three are equal. And FLB equal to FNR, FLB equal to FNR, because these two are symmetrical. So similarity rule, symmetrical rule, FLB equal to FNR equal to 0.4. We write the equation once again, FLA plus FLB plus FLC equal to 0.8. So, we said FLA equal to FLC, FLA equal to FLC. So, 2 FLA and plus FLB equal to 0.8 and 2 FLA, FLB, we said FLB equal to FNR equal to 0.4. So, 2 FLA plus 0.4 equal to 0.8. So, FLA equal to 0.2. Now, FPQ, FPQ equal to FPD plus FPE, FPD equal to FNR, because it is symmetrical, so it is perfectly at the bottom, plus FLA, PE equal to LA, so that is equal to 0.4 plus 0.2 equal to 0.6. So, we are using the similarity rule, so this is one important rule in the calculating shape factor for the radiation heat transfer. So, reciprocity rule, summation rule, these two are very important rules. You have to, similarity rule, that is also important. You have to remember and using the similarity rule, this problem is completely based on the similarity rule and summation rule. Next problem from the 1989 question paper. Two black plates, each 1 meter square, are placed parallel to each other in such a way that radiation shape factor for the system is 0.4. If the plate are maintained at 800 Kelvin and 800 degree Celsius and 400 degree Celsius respectively, determine the net radiant heat transfer between the plates. Also calculate the net heat exchange if the plate were infinite in size. Stephen Boltzmann constant is given as 5.67 10 power minus 8 watts per meter square Kelvin. So the black plates, the two black plates of 1 meter square are placed parallel to each with the shape factor 0.4. So when the for the square plate, the shape factor is 0.4. So first we calculate radiation heat exchange between the black plates. So Q equal to F12 sigma into T12 to the power 4 minus T2 to the power 4. So calculating 0.4 into 5.67 10 power minus 8 into 1073.4 to the power 4 minus 673 to the power 4 equal to 25,411 watts per meter square. Now when the plates become infinite, if the plates are infinite length, so then F12 equal to F21 equal to 1. So the for infinite plates, shape factor equal to 1. So in the same equation, substitute F12, replace F12 is dropped here. So Q equal to sigma into T1 to the power 4 minus T2 to the power 4. So calculating 5.67 10 power minus 8, 1073 to the power 4 minus 673 to the power 4 equal to 63,527 watts per meter square. So this is the answer, two answer.
The next question from 1991 question paper. An object has a shape of cubical box of side 10 cm with no top cover. The box is placed inside a room whose dimensions are much larger than those of the box. All the five surfaces of the box are kept at temperature 500 degrees Celsius and have emissivity of 0.6. The walls of the room is at 25 degrees Celsius and have emissivity of 0.4. All these surfaces can be assumed to be diffuse and gray. Find the net radiative heat loss from the box to the wall of the room. The Stephen Boltzmann constant is 5.67 10 power minus 8 watts per meter square Kelvin to the power 4. The view factor between the two parallel square plates placed directly opposite to each other is 0.2. So, view factor between two parallel square plates placed perfectly opposite each other is 0.2. That we have to calculate. So we take the room. This is the box. We have five surfaces. Left side surface, right side surface, bottom surface, front surface and the rear surface. And the top cover, top surface, there is no top surface. So through the opening, the radiation is leaving. And we have the box in the room. And what is given? Temperature of the box is 500 degrees Celsius, which is 773 Kelvin. Temperature of room is 25 degrees Celsius, 298 Kelvin. Epsilon, all the surfaces of the box are at emissivity 0.6. The emissivity of the room is 0.4. So, F13 radiation, the square plates are perfectly opposite. F13 equal to 0.2. F2R, so from the 2, it is falling, radiation falling on the room, it is also 0.2. Now, the radiation leaving, summation rule for the radiation leaving from the first surface, F11 plus F12 plus F13 plus F14 plus F15 plus F1R equal to 1. So, 1 to 2, 1 to 3, 1 to 4, 1 to 5 and 1 to room. So, the heat transfer. Now we have F12 equal to F14 equal to F15 equal to F1R. F12 equal to F13 equal to F14 equal to F15 equal to F1R. And F11 equal to 0. Why F11 equal to 0? There is no energy is leaving the first plate falling on the same surface again. So, all the values are equal, so 4F1R equal to 1 minus F13, which is 1 minus 0.2 equal to 0.8. So, F1R equal to 0.2. So, amount of fraction of energy leaving the surface 1, that is falling on the room, it is 0.2. Now, the heat transfer between the surface 1 and the room. We have to calculate the heat transfer between the surface 1 and the room. This is Q1R equal to sigma into T1 to the power 4 minus TR to the power 4 divided by 1 by epsilon 1 minus by A1 epsilon 1 plus 1 by A1 F1R plus 1 by epsilon 2, 1 by epsilon r divided by ar epsilon r. Now I take the area A1. A1 is the area of the square surface. A1 to the numerator. So this will be 1 minus epsilon 1 divided by epsilon 1 plus 1 by F1R plus A1 by AR into 1 minus epsilon R divided by epsilon R. Now here AR, area of the room, is very much larger than the area of the square surface A1. So when AR is very much greater than A1, A1 by AR tends to in 0. When this is tends to 0, and the equation simplified like this. So, Q into A1 into T1 to the power 4 minus TR to the power 4 divided by 1 minus epsilon 1 by epsilon 1 plus 1 by F1R. So, this has become 0. Now, the heat transfer, substituting numerical values, 5.67 10 power minus 8 into 0.1 into 0.1. Area of the surface is 0.1 into 0.1, 773 to the power 4 minus 298 to the power 4. So, 1 minus 0.6 divided by 0.6. plus 1 by 0.2 plus 0. So, calculating the heat transfer from the surface 1 to the room is 34.396 watts. Now, the total heat transfer, all the surfaces are the similar, similar area, similar temperature, same emissivity. So, the total heat transfer, 5 surfaces are there, 5 into 34.936 equal to 174.68 watts. The next question, from 1995 question paper, consider two large parallel plates, one at 727 degrees Celsius with the emissivity 0.8 and other at 227 degrees Celsius with the emissivity 0.4. An aluminium radiation shield with the emissivity of 0.05 on both sides is placed between them. Calculate the percentage of reduction in the heat transfer between the two plates as a result of this shield. The Stefan Boltzmann constant is 5.67 10 power minus 8. So we
write down the given data. T1 equal to 727 degrees Celsius, which is 1000 Kelvin. T2 equal to 227 degrees Celsius, which is 500 Kelvin. Epsilon 1 equal to 0.8. Epsilon 2 equal to 0.4. And the shield, emissivity of the shield is 0.05. Now heat transfer without shield. So we write the equation Q equal to sigma A into T1 to the power 4 minus T2 to the power 4. Divided by 1 by epsilon 1 plus 1 by epsilon 2 minus 1. So, we take area equal to 1 meter square. So, substituting 5.67 10 power minus 8 into 1 into 1000 to the power 4 minus 500 to the power 4 divided by 1 by 0.8 plus 1 by 0.4 minus 1, which is 19,329.5 watts. Now, heat transfer with the shield. So, when there is a shield, we have to add the resistance of the emissivity of the resistance due to the emissivity of the radiation shield. So, sigma A into T1 to the power 4 minus T2 to the power 4 divided by resistance 1 by epsilon 1 plus 1 by epsilon 2 minus 1 plus 2 by epsilon S minus 1. So, this is the resistance due to the radiation shield. So, substituting numerical values 5.61 10 power minus 8 into 1 into 1000 to the power 4 minus 500 to the power 4 divided by 1 by 0.8 plus 1 by 0.4 minus 1 plus 2 by 0.05 minus 1, calculating 1260.6 watt. So, the percentage reduction of the heat transfer Q minus QS divided by Q. So, QS is the amount of heat transfer with the shield and Q is the heat transfer without shield. So, 19,329.5 minus 1260.6 divided by 19,329.5 into 100 equal to 93.4%. Next question from 2000 question paper. A thin metal plate is exposed to solar radiation. The air and the surrounding are at 30 degrees Celsius. The heat transfer coefficient for by free convection from the upper surface of the plate is 17.4 watts per meter square Kelvin. The plate has an absorbability of 0.9 at solar wavelength and an emissivity of 0.1 at a long wavelength. Neglecting any heat loss from the lower surface, determine the incident solar radiation intensity in kilowatts per meter square if the measured equilibrium temperature of the plate is 50 degrees Celsius. So, Stefan Boltzmann constant is 5.67 in 10 power minus 8 watts per meter square Kelvin to the power 4. And the given data, the surface temperature is 30 degrees Celsius, heat transfer coefficient is 17.4 watts per meter square Kelvin, emissivity of the surface is 0.1, absorbability of the surface is 0.9 and temperature is 50 degrees Celsius. Now, heat absorbed by the plate by solar radiation equal to 0.9 times of radiation heat incident on the plate. So, because the 0.9 is the absorbity. So, whatever the incident on the plate, only 0.9 value, 90% only absorbed. So, heat absorbed by the plate equal to 0.9 into heat incident on the plate. So, 0.9 into Q equal to heat transfer by convection and plus heat transfer by radiation between the plate and the surrounding. Now, we calculate 0.9 Q, heat transfer by convection, HAP into delta T. AP is the area of the plate plus sigma into T1 to the power 4 minus TS to the power 4. So, which is divided by 1 by epsilon divided by AP epsilon. This is the resistance due to the surface emissivity. 1 by AP into F12, this is the resistance to the shape factor. 1 by epsilon S divided by AS epsilon S, this is the resistance due to the emissivity of the surrounding. Now, 0.9Q equal to HAP delta T, and I take AP to the numerator, sigma AP into T to the power 4 minus TS to the power 4 divided by 1 minus epsilon divided by epsilon plus 1 by F12 plus AP by AS into 1 minus epsilon S divided by epsilon S. AP is the area of the plate, A is the area of the surrounding. AS is very much greater than AP, and AP by AS tends to 0 and F12 equal to 1, because whatever the energy leaving from the surface, it is completely falling, solar radiation is completely falling on the plate. So, substituting all the numerical values, 0.9 Q by AP equal to HA delta T plus sigma into T1 T to the power 4. So, the same equation. And the substitute numerical value is 17.4 into 20 plus 5.6 on 10 power minus 8 into 323 to the power 4 minus 303 to the power 4 divided by 1 minus 0.1 divided by 0.1 plus 1 by 1. So, calculating Q by AP, heat transfer per area of the plate, 402.1 watts per meter square. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I published in mechanical engineering. And I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures of the subject and the gate solution in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the video lectures for your better preparation and passing the gate examination. So, thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. So, we'll meet again with another video on the solution of gate question paper in mechanical engineering subject.